My main goal was there to photograph the behavior and the habitat of Narconda hornbills, which are only found in that tiny island, and they're not found anywhere in the world. I went to Narcondam Island during March 2013 with Dr. Shirish Manchi and Dr. Asad Ramani, and also one field assistant was with us. We were dropped there by Coast Guard, and after 18 days we were collected by them. When I visited, all the Narcondam hornbills were very busy all over the island. Some were active in making their nest, some were feeding in the nest, some were feeding in the trees, and some hornbills were doing the display rituals in the sky. A whole day I got a chance to observe all these activities around the place I stayed. These birds are mainly canopy dwellers, and I wanted to photograph them from the eye level, so that this eye level perspective of the photograph can create an intimate relationship with the bird and the viewers of the photograph. And for that, when I reached the island, I did a short survey of the place, just to know in which trees they feed, or in which trees they made the nest, and where they roost, and their movement patterns. And I identified one beautiful fig tree where a good number of Narcondam hornbills used to feed. And 40 feet above the tree, I found a space in between the branches where I can sit for the whole day in the eye level with the birds. And next 5-6 days, I used to sit at that space above the tree from morning to evening to observe the birds and to photograph the activities of the birds. To photograph the nesting hornbills, I avoided to climb the same tree in which the nest was made, so that they will not be disturbed by my activities. But to reach the eye level to the nest, I fixed a rope in a tree which was close but in a safe distance from the tree with the actual nest. What I observed in the nest, that the female was locked inside and the male used to bring the food periodically for the female. After every two rounds of fruit feeding, the male hornbill used to carry some insects for the female. So there was always a supply of proteins, and the male used to maintain the balance in the diet. In those 18 days of experience in that tiny volcanic island, I found the ecosystem was very, very fragile. And so the survival of this beautiful but vulnerable hornbill species will depend on how minimum we can keep our so-called development activities over this beautiful island.